Hello guys, this is Thomas from Hotkey404 and in this video I will show you how to configure from source Asterisk DAC-D channels and E1, T1 digital cards. But before we get to that, let's start with a few words of introduction. Some time ago I was thinking about a subject that might be of interest to all those who subscribe to this channel or just come here from time to time to find some practical information about configuring their VoIP servers. But then I remembered that we had collected a lot of old Digium cards at our previous company. So I decided to call my former employer and ask him if he could send us the cards so that we could see if we could use any of those for his clients. After a few days, I received a package containing various analog and digital cards with some modules, of course. After a quick look, it turned out that we could save a lot on hardware, and instead of buying expensive gateways with digital ports, we can use used cards that we bought for a fraction of a cost, so basically super cheap, and we can save a lot of money. So in this video we will do a complete Asterisk setup with DAC-D channels, and we will compile a libpri library support. And I will also show you how to avoid or solve some common problems that might occur during the installation. We will also test our configuration using an external gateway and do some internal tests. However, I will assume that you have already seen our other videos on how to install Asterisk from source. In this video, we will take Asterisk 16 and CentOS 7 as a starting point, but of course, the commands that we will use should be similar in other newer versions of hardware or software. But of course, if you haven't installed Asterisk from source yet, link to some other videos can be found in the description. And using some good security policies, I decided to change the user from root to Asterisk. Also, all of that information can be found on our website hotkey404.com in a blog section. Link, you know where to find it. And if you'd like to see how to install other cards with FXO, FXS or ISDN ports, let me know in a comment section. But enough of that, let's get started. And maybe just one more word, I'm not going to compile everything at once. So you will see some errors because I want to show you what is linked to what. Some DAC-D channels, some Asterisk files, some libpri libraries. So we'll do this library after library, module after module, so that you'll see how all of that is interlinked. Okay, so let's start with our Chan DAC-D compilation. And first we'll test our hardware with lspci, and if you didn't find the command, we will install it, but just to highlight it quickly, if you type who am I, you'll see that I'm executing commands as root. So if you're executing commands as a different user, just type sudo before every command or switch user. So to install our lspci utilities, I'm going to type yum-y install PCI utils, and this will give us the possibility to execute this command. And with lspci, you will see that we have our communications controller, that is Digium wildcard TE210P, which is basically our dual port card. Now, since I like to have my files organized, I'm going to continue to user src directory with cd. And then with wget download DAC-D Linux current and DAC-D tools. Then with tar-zxvf, we are going to untar DAC-D Linux. And then with the same command, we are going to extract the second downloaded file, that is DAC-D tools current tar-gz. We will start now with DAC-D Linux. So cd DAC-D hyphen Linux hyphen, I'll just put asterisk because you know, it might be difficult to say which version you downloaded depending on when you watch the video. And then after downloading, if I type make,
you will see that there is this warning that you do not appear to have the sources for our kernel. So to download that, let's type yum-y install and then kernel-devil and kernel-headers. And these two will be needed later. So once we've downloaded that, once again, let's execute our make command. Having that step behind us, let's execute make install. And it will install our drivers for basically every compatible cart. As soon as it finishes, it will show that drivers are installed successfully, but if you have not done it before, install the package dagdi tools. To do that, we have to go back one directory with cd dot dot and then continue to cd dagdi tools, and I'll just type asterisk to go with a proper version that we downloaded. If you check the content of this directory, you'll see with ls that we have this nice bootstrap.sh script, but if we try to execute it with .slash and bootstrap.sh, it will show us that we are missing one library, that is libtools. To do that, let's execute yum-y install libtool, and now, once again, if we execute bootstrap.sh, we'll see no warning. So the next logical step would be to execute .slash and configure, and here, once again, we are missing some libraries. Well, maybe not exactly libraries, but some scripts and tools that are required. So to install those, let's type libtoolies, and then aclocal, automake, and after hyphens, add missing. And the last one, autoconf. Although you see no output, now going back to our .slash configure, as you'll see, this is nicely done. Now dagdi tools build successfully configured, so we can execute make all, make install, and then make install config. And as you see in the box, this will install some init script that will help us later during the configuration. Also, this last command, this install config, will detect that we have one dagdi device, and it will notice that this is this wildcard TE210P, and it will load this WCT4XXP driver. Then, also, it suggests that we run dagdi genconf modules to load support for only this one card, except for loading all of the drivers that were compiled during our configuration. Then we want to adjust the contents of etc, udef, rules.d, dagdi.rules, and here we might see the configuration, the user group of our dagdi card, and without changing this, you might see some problems with opening the device. And this happened to me, so make sure that, for example, if you're running my user changed the asterisk and the group to this user that is the owner of the card, so that you won't see the permissions error. Next, since we have created our drivers, you might want to enter asterisk console with asterisk hyphen r, and then at this point I would like to load the module, but if I type load module and try to locate chan dagdi, it is not here. And why is that? Because during our asterisk compilation we didn't have proper drivers, so this chan dagdi so file was not created. To create it, unfortunately, we have to recompile our asterisk. And if you're thinking how to do this, just go back on our website and you'll see how to download the sources. I have them here in our user SSC directory, so I'm going to continue to this asterisk-16.12 28.0, and then I'm going to once again run configure option. And since I'm doing this with some additional settings, I'm going to type ./configure and then after hyphen libdir, which is user lib64, and then with PJ project bundled and with Janson bundled. As it finishes, I will just show you that we have created a proper module. So with make menu select, you'll notice that after we enter the menu, if we go to this section with channel drivers, this is second from the top, we have Chan Dahdi, and a bit below we have Chan MISDN, which is an older driver for the cards, but we are not longer using a deprecated module, so we'll stick to this one. So since we're sure that we have Dahdi capabilities, let's execute make, and after it compiles, make install. Let's change our directory to etc asterisk. At this stage, there's no need to make samples, make basic PBX, because we already have our configuration. So we will just load our module. To do that, let's enter our asterisk console with asterisk hyphen R. And then if we type module load, and as you start typing and press tab on your keyboard, you'll see that it will auto suggest loading our Chan Dahdi SO file. But as you see, as we try to load the file, we see that we are unable to load config file, that is chan_dahdi.conf. We'll fix that in a second, but before we get to that, let's quickly check our modules. So since we are in etc asterisk directory, we can just edit our modules.conf file. And here it depends on your configuration. You have a few options. You could go with auto load set to yes, and then you won't need all those files that I'm loading manually. But since I want to keep things organized, and well, this is just what I prefer, I'm going to manually load chan_dahdi.so file, and then it will be automatically loaded next time I restart my asterisk. Then if I check the status of our Dahdi services with systemctl status Dahdi, you'll see that, well, it's loaded but inactive. Basically, it's dead. So let's reboot our system, and all of our services, basically Dahdi services with our asterisk, will be loaded once again, and it will help us with our next configuration. So let's just type reboot. After a restart or a reboot, let's once again check the status of our Dahdi, and this won't work. It will show with system status Dahdi that the activation failed because we are missing some configuration files. And then all of the tools that we downloaded, this Dahdi tools, comes in handy. As you start typing Dahdi_ and then hit tab twice, you'll see a lot of extra tools that you might want to use during your configuration. For example, Dahdi hardware will show this one card that we have present in our system. We also have, for example, Dahdi tests that will measure the accuracy of our Dahdi interface. But, you know, let's stop this for now. Also, we have, I think, one of the most important tools, which is Dahdi GenConf. And with hyphen H, you'll see some options that you might want to use. I really suggest you check our website, and we have all those options nicely explained. We'll go with Dahdi_GenConf. And then hyphen small v, which will not show us the version, but generate our files. Then, since we have those files, we are going to check the content of those. For example, if we edit etc.dahdi.system.conf, we have our spans. You could try to change, for example, time zone in global data section. Then let's check our etc asterisk dahdi-channels.conf file. And this is auto-generated, as it says at the beginning, by this genconf script. And if necessary, feel free to edit the configuration. Since we have two spans, we see two groups. And for example, you can change the context, some dialing options here, but we'll get back to this file in a second. What is really important at this point, let's execute dacty underscore cfg, that is config with some v's after hyphen, and this will create our main configuration file. Here it will set all the configuration. You can set up some echo cancellers, some spans, you'll see the status of your channels. Also, we have this HDLC with FCS check, and this is also explained on our website. This is a check to test the capabilities of our pre-pra, however you call it, this digital signal. This is required here. You might think that you have 32 channels, but actually two of those, the first one and the middle one, are just for checking the signal. And while it's true that I talked about creating a configuration file, that is not an asterisk configuration file. So let's enter cd etc asterisk, and here we have dacty channels owned by root, but we don't have our dacty.conf file. So if you followed our tutorial and you have samples directory, you can go to samples and then just copy the file with cp and copy our chan underscore dacty.conf file into etc asterisk. So going up one directory with ls, you will see those two files. All we have to do right now is to change the owner of those two files, and I will use chown asterisk, and this is going to be asterisk user and group. Then we will select the first one, chan underscore dacty.conf file, and use the same command, and after delimiter you can just type the second dacty-channels file. But those two are not connected yet. How do we know that? Because if we enter asterisk console with asterisk hyphen r and enter, for example, dacty restart, or let's say dacty show status, it will show the status of the card, but we are actually unable to use it yet. Even if you execute core reload, you will see some errors with some missing files, because this is a really basic configuration. I don't have any features ACL or CL configuration, but you don't see any dacty errors. What is the reason? I will just quickly exit the console, clear the screen. And then, since I'm in etc asterisk directory, if I execute ls with hyphen l, because I really like it sorted like this, you'll see that we have two files, dacty-channels.conf, but it is not linked to chan underscore dacty.conf file. To connect them, let's enter the second one. So I will just copy the name of this dacty channels file and then enter chan underscore dacty. As you open the file, you'll see a lot of configuration with trunk groups, channel configurations, a lot of explanation. This is a sample file after all, so you'll see all the details about the configuration. So I'm just scrolling just to show you how many possibilities are here with those dacty channels. But as we scroll, and yeah, still going to the end, going, oh really, I forgot the file is so long. Yeah, one uncommented line, still going. Yeah, call waiting set to yes, still barking, echo cancellation. So, very long file, and well, that was interesting. Some gain options. So, for example, if you have some problems with the volume of the sounds, or someone barely hears you, or you barely hear someone else, just set up your gains. And yeah, so this is super long. I will just skip to the end, sorry. Okay, so great, we're here. So at the end of the file, we will just press hash include and the name of our file. So since this is now included, if we enter once again our asterisk console and press asterisk restart, it will show some warnings, but actually this is good information because it shows that we detected alarm on channel number one, channel number two, and so on, but the card is detected by asterisk at this point. However, there is a second problem because we see some unknown signaling method, and this is because we compiled our DAGD channel without the support of E1 cards. And I know, as I explained at the beginning, I did it on purpose so that you'll know what is connected to what, why do you need some libraries. At this point, since we know that we need some extra libraries, let's go once again to our CD USR SRC directory. Let's download one more library. And once again, we'll need to compile asterisk to enable the support, but this will go a lot faster. As usual, we'll use wget to download current libpri libraries, and then we're going to extract the file with tar-zxvf. After it finishes, let's continue to our libpri directory and execute make. As soon as it finishes, let's execute make install. This will take just a second, and we'll go back to our user SRC directory, and we'll have to go one level up, and then CD into asterisk directory. Here we will once again configure our software. So once again, we'll use libdir with USR, lib64 with a PJ project bundled and with a Janson bundled. Now, without going to make menu select, let's execute make and then make install. As soon as it finishes, and this will once again take just a few seconds because we have all of our modules already pre-configured, let's restart our services with systemctl restart DAGD and system restart asterisk. We should be able to load all of the dependencies. Let's enter our asterisk with asterisk hyphen r, and I'll enter some v's for verbosity. And here you see with DAGD show channels, we have all of our channels configured. If we restart, you will once again see some alarms, but you don't have this missing signaling error, which is actually a good news. But there's a question. How do you actually check if the card works? To test this, we'll have to use one of the tools that we have already downloaded. But before we get to that, let's stop the asterisk service with core stop now. And let's go to CD USR SRC and our DAGD tools. Here in this directory, we have an option to make an internal test. To start the test, let's execute some commands. First, we will make patloop test, that is this internal test. Then we will enable digital loopback on span number one with the command DAGD underscore maint. And then this span number one, so hyphen S1, then hyphen L, that is localhost. Next, we will run a test on channel number one with the command ./patloop test and then one minus T10. And this will loop through the data interface. If this finished nicely, with no errors, and you see here that it runs some loops with zero errors, We can execute dagdmaint-s1-l off, and this will turn off this span, this internal test, so we can once again start our service, that is systemctl start asterisk, and check the status with dagd show status. Well, still red. Nothing changed here.
Let's be honest, while preparing the documentation for this material, I thought about finishing it at the path loop test stage. But then I remembered that for testing purposes, we can do at least two different things. First, since our card has two ports, we can connect them together and see if they synchronize. After reviewing some documentation, I crimped the Ethernet patch cord, and after connecting, the card turned green. Secondly, I decided to rent a professional YesStar TE100 gateway, and to fully test the synchronization, I prepared the following devices. On one hand, we have our server with E1 card installed inside. On the other, we have our YesStar gateway with SIP to E1 and E1 to SIP routing configured. Also, we connected another asterisk to the gateway with one SIP account, and I assigned a public number 888888888, but of course the number is fictional, it's just to check the ability to make a connection. And of course not. This video is not sponsored by YesStar. But enough of that, let's make some noise. I mean, some tests.
After logging to our YesStar gateway, let's go to gateway and our digital trunk status, and we have one trunk. And what is really important here to check if the configuration, like the signaling, encryption and so on, matches the configuration in your asterisk. Meantime, let's open our asterisk console. And here we have, for example, DAG show channels, and we have all of our channels. Then, with DAGD show status, we will see two spans. The alarm says this is still red. And if you connect a regular patch cord, you'll see that it is still red. Nothing's happening here because you know from the beginning of this video that you need to crimp your patch cord according to digital configuration, which is specifically designed for those kind of patch cords. So if I replace the cable and take the one that I crimped, well, you see it's a bit different than a regular cable. So now if I insert it into our YesStar gateway and connect it to my E1 port in my server, after a second it will show that the primary D channel on span 1 is up, and then all of the alarms are cleared, which actually tells us that everything after restart is working right now. If you want to verify, once again type DAGD show status, and you will see that there is an OK message on one of the alarms, so basically there is no alarm. Just verify CRC and other options that I mentioned regarding your YesStar gateway if you plan on using it or just testing it. Also, as I mentioned a few minutes ago, for testing purposes, I've configured two routes, E1 to SIP and SIP to E1. I configured my E1 trunk. So having all that routing configured, I've created a second PBX. Well, this is called TTPBX because, you know, these are initials of my name and my surname. So having that, I've created a SIP account. Well, this is 103 SIP account with a virtual number of some 8s. And then to see if this is actually working, I'm going to type channel originate dagd/g1, and g1, this is group 0, so this will use any port from first span, and then some 8s. And to check if this works, I'm going to play application music on hold, because who doesn't like to listen to a good music? So since I'm dialing, you'll see that this first port is flashing orange, and if I accept or answer the call, then after reload it will turn green, which actually means that we are using the first channel of this first port here. If we were to execute the same command once again, it won't go through because you'll see the response busy here because I'm already talking to my server. Okay, so you might be wondering, but what if you are not using Asterisk like I do? You use FreePBX, ESLPBX, some, you know, server with a graphic interface. If you have one of those, I chose ESLPBX for testing purposes. I'll show you quickly that it actually works. Having that in mind, let's go to our server, login, go to hardware detector. And although it shows the ports are green, actually that means it means that there is a problem because the ports are not detected by Asterisk. So we will do a span configuration, span parameters, and here for example I will change from T1 to E1, that is Europe. This is where I live and this is what I'm using in my tests. So after changing all of that and adjusting to your needs, let's replace our chan-d.conf file. You click detect or regenerate the configuration, and after a second of detecting hardware, all of the ports will switch from green, which is not detected, to red. And it is an indication that the port has been detected by the Asterisk. It's not in service, which is obvious because we disconnected all of our cables, our patch cords, but it actually means that the card is properly detected. So if you see green at the beginning, it's wrong, then red, it's okay, but after you connect, it's even better. And just to show you how it looks in a CLI, let's switch to our console. Here after logging in as root in my case, I will show you that DAGDI hardware will show the same card, and then asterisk hyphen R. Well, this is a different user. This is not an Asterisk user, but a root user. But still, DAGDI show status will show the same card. So as you see, the configuration is pretty simple. DAGDI show channels also will show the same 62 ports that we generated in our configuration.
Okay, that's it for this episode. I hope I was able to clearly explain how to compile DAGDI channels for Asterisk and how to add libpri support. And as I mentioned in the introduction, if you want to see some similar configuration of analog or digital cards, let me know in the comment section. We have a lot of cards still waiting. But until then, have an amazing day and see you in the next one.